Soup has lots of neat stuff and lots of neat flavors. All right, Bison. Where do we begin? Movement? His walk speed is abysmal. It's actually tied for lowest in the game. The back walk speed is noticeably a little faster than the forward. I'm pretty sure it's faster. No, I'm not super certain. A lot of characters have slower back walk speed than forward walk speed. These might be the same speed, but the back walk speed is a little bit better than, like, what his forward walk speed implies, which is what I think I'm seeing. It might be the same speed. Bison as a substitute for Makoto, that's pretty interesting. I usually see Makoto players switching to Mika, actually. Or Laura or Cammy. Those are like the really common switches. Let's talk about Bison. Foot speed is terrible. Dash speed is incredible. His back dash is pretty good. His forward dash actually has true invincibility when he's invisible. Invincible, I'm pretty sure to throws, but definitely to hits. And that's like full body. And it also goes through fireballs, albeit it's pretty hard to time. I don't know if I have a Ryu throwing a fireball. So let's just record one really fast. That was a slow fireball. That's like the absolute hardest one to do. There you go. That was a hard one. The faster a fireball is, the easier it is. But you can dash through fireballs as Bison. It's not really practical outside of V-Trigger, but we'll talk about it once V-Trigger gets into the mix. I don't know the window on this. I've only seen people do it. That looked like I did it a little late. I mean, a little early. Okay, I can't even do this. How do you do it? What's the trick? Someone tell me. Oh, it's just I was doing it super late. You gotta do it early. I thought I was getting hit out of the invincibility. There you go. It's precise to time that with a fireball outside of V-Trigger, but the window is much bigger in V-Trigger, and we'll get to that when it comes up. But that he does have true invincibility on his forward dash, which can be situationally very useful. And it's also an insanely fast forward dash. Like, a forward dash into throw is actually surprisingly really hard to react to. And even if you do react and tech the throw yourself, if Bison just goes into, like, jab or something, he'll counter hit your throw startup. Like, that's how fast it is. He can dash and jab before you can react to the dash and throw. And one thing a lot of people do is they just do dash in stand hard kick. And that stand hard kick is a safe on block, actually plus on block normal, that also leads to his crush counters. So it's like he can actually dash and get that standard hard kick out before the opponent would be able to hit a button. Sometimes it depends on how ready the opponent is to hit him. You can do empty cancels to counter that. You can do like with Ryu, you can do like a crouch medium kick cancel to Tatsu, and if Bison dashes into that crouch medium kick, the crouch medium kick hits him and the Tatsu comes out. But if Bison doesn't dash, the crouch medium kick just whiffs, so it's not super unsafe. Empty cancels are pretty good at countering that forward dash, but it's still kind of risky. It's kind of risky for Bison as well, because he can't just dash into a poke or something. But it is surprisingly fast. His jump is pretty big. It's one of the bigger jumps in the game. It's not as big as it was in Street Fighter 4, but he does go up quite high, and he does jump quite far. It's more normal. It's less weird. It used to be a very strange jump with the crazy... Hold on a second. Got him back. My brother came into my room. Apologize. Let me see here. What was I talking about? That like completely removed me from things. His movement's good, okay? This is the end. Let's talk normals. His crouch jab goes pretty far. His stand short goes incredibly far. His stand jab is pretty fast, I think. V-frame, save me. Tell me what all these normal speeds are. I'm pretty sure stand jab is 4 frames. I'm pretty sure he doesn't have a 3-frame normal. Yeah, everything is 4. And... the crouch side kick is +3, so you've got a chain to get out of it. Alright. Anyway, typical Bison combos. You can combo out of light normals with both the burst, the Psycho Blast, and light scissor kick. Very common to use either of those. Bison actually has really great conversions from light normals. Doesn't that work? I thought that worked. I guess you have to use standard light kick. Yeah. I didn't know that didn't work from jab. That's surprising to me. But like really common Bison confirms are like that. I thought that worked. What the hell? That doesn't cancel, I think, right? Yeah. That is like a really common one. That's a plus. That's a three frame conversion. So you've got to keep back charge for that entire string, which is a little precise for people who aren't used to that sort of thing. But like, if you play a lot of charge characters, you'll be really good at getting maintaining charge during combos that switch back and forth between crouching and standing. And you're just going from down back to straight back or straight back to down back. Bison, fortunately, doesn't have any combos that go from standing to crouching in this game. He had quite a few in Street Fighter 4. Let's see here. What's the two-hit one? That, I guess? I thought that Light Scissor worked there. I really thought that worked. That surprises me. And you can't do crouch short, stand short. So I guess your normal conversion off a low isn't a blast, Psycho Burst, or whatever. And if you want to do the three-hit version, you can go into Light Scissor Kick. I'm just surprised that doesn't work, though. You've got to do the three-hit version if you want to combo out of the low. You can just do low jab, stand shorts. And you can just do that as a two-hit conversion, or you can do two stand shorts for the three-hit version. And those natively build charge. Like, if I don't have charge at all, I'll have charge by the end of the combo. Bison has a lot of stuff that natively builds charge, and that's important because you won't always have charge when you're starting your combos. But that's, like, Bison normals in a nutshell. They're all pretty much interchangeable when punishing stuff. I think stand short goes barely the farthest. I'm not going to watch a fucking Bison combo right now. I'm fucking recording a tutorial. And he can confirm into a lot of safe things off of them. So Bison, even though he doesn't have a true reversal, is really good at resisting pressure by merit of his normals. Like, if the opponent does something that's minus even a single frame, you can do that stand short into blast and get yourself out of pressure. Or even something that's neutral on block. That'll beat anything except like a three frame normal. So like you can resist pressure like super well with Bison just by canceling into one of his safe special moves. You don't need to confirm those two with Bison. You kind of need to in some characters. Some characters can hit the Light Scissor Kick unless you space it. That was an example of a spaced one. This is really hard to punish. But like from here, some characters on block can hit Bison. He's minus four there if they block it. They're all safe on hit. But like that's the kind of mindset you need to have with Bison if you're trying to escape the opponent's pressure, is to watch for something that you can hit a button after. Pretty much anything except a plus move, and you should know all the plus moves in this game. That's like important information. If you spot a move that's not, if you spot any move except a move that's plus on block, like stand short into light blast, or like stand jab into light blast, pushes them out even if it's blocked. And if it isn't blocked, you get a knockdown and some damage. So that's like pretty useful. Let's see here. Medium normals, I guess. Stand strong is frame advantage. It's actually, I think it's like neutral on block, right? Or even minus one. Let me see here. No, it's plus two. That's quite a lot. Bison's frame data is in general pretty incredible. Plus two for that. So if you do that into like low strong, that's a four frame window on block. So like, and that like, you'll be trading like a. The opponent has to go for a light normal because the only light normals, the only four frame moves in the game are all light normals, I think. You'll be trading like a light normal with a crouch strong. If it even trades at all, crouch strong might just win. So this is like a really good little string, and it's also a combo. And it natively builds charge. Stand strong, low strong. A lot of people will go into Inferno there. But Scissor Kick has different conversions, and the conversions can be better. But I was just showing off that you can charge during it. It requires a slightly late cancel, but it's possible. Let's see here. Stand Strong is really good after a cross-up where your other combo starters don't work. Like, Bison's Link starters are down towards Fierce, which is retardedly slow, or Stand Hard Kick, which is pretty slow. And it's pretty hard to get, like, a cross-up into a Stand Hard Kick. It's possible, but it's usually impractical. And even if you can do the timing where you get the hit, you get the combo, if they block the first hit, they can interrupt the second hit. Like, the window between the attacks is much bigger, which is bad. So typically after, like, a cross-up medium kick, you want to go for the stand strong as a combo starter. It's a nice little hit confirm. Something like that is very common from Bison. So stand strong is like a, it's got nice range. I don't think you can link into it at all, but you can link out of it into the low strong, and it does go pretty far. You can't confirm out of it if you're far away, but it does go pretty far. And no, nothing in this game is plus six on block. Standard hard kick is barely plus six on hit. It's like plus two on block, I think. Let's see here. That's like stand strong in a nutshell. Low strong is the move that you're always trying to combo into. It's six frames, which is the fastest. The fastest button Bison has, except for light normals, which are all four. So he has a lot of attacks that are plus six, and this is the move that you're always trying to combo into because it has good conversions. Usually you want to combo into the, yeah, the medium version of Inferno. I just tried the hard version to make sure it didn't work. That's like his main, that's his max damage ender. You can combo into medium scissor kick as well, which does a little bit less, but has interesting conversions with V-trigger. So low strong. Low strong is like a typical punish. Like if you block, like let's say, an Akeli dash attack, charge attack, low strong is a punish on it, and the combo from into Inferno will pick up. Conversions from this combo, you can do super as a cancel. And that's really good when it works. I'm not going to let the animation play out. But it's worth noting that if you're getting a punish for something, like if you're fighting Akeli, and Akeli does a charge dash attack, you're probably going to be like this far away. Maybe like this far away. And that punish will still work, but there are ranges where the punish will still work where the super fails to connect. That was still in range. But it is an awful thing when it happens. It's being pretty consistent here. I don't think I'll be able to activate it like that. But it's worth noting that it can happen. Actually, it's looking pretty reliable, so maybe just always do that. Maybe if you do a late super cancel, it doesn't work. I don't know. Anyway, that's like a really good conversion from the Inferno. The motion's a bit weird, but the Inferno takes a long time, so you can do the motion pretty easily. It's down back to get the Inferno, and down forward to get the super. So you just do like down back, down forward, it's really fast. You just do one long motion. It's like quarter circle back, half circle forward, quarter circle forward for your like total motion. Looks like that. Anyway, let's see. It is the combo that you're always trying to go for after like every normally has. That's like its main purpose. Stand hard kick into low strong, down towards fierce into low strong, stand strong into low strong. It's like the normal that you're going into. And if you want to do, if you don't want to do a link in your combo, you can just go low strong. You don't need everything else. But in combos like those, stand fierce is actually better. Stand forward is a poke. It's one of the better pokes in the game, mostly because every other poke has gotten nerfed, and this one is about as good as it ever was. Slightly worse. It goes really far. Ryu wouldn't be able to hit me from anything, hit me with anything from this range, except for like towards fierce and maybe a sweep. I think that's too far for sweep, but I can still tag him with a stand forward. It's like really far that this move works. Hits from a range where other characters usually don't have options. There's pretty much no reward to it. It's 60 damage plus 100 stun. It's not super rewarding, but there's very little risk to it. It's just like a good little button to control space. Every character has like at least one good poke, and this is Bison's. But Bison has a couple others that are still pretty good. Let's see here. Crouch forward is pretty slow, but it has a very recessed hurt box, and it goes farther than it appears to. Like, it's got kind of a deceptively good animation to it. A lot of leg attacks don't hit all the way down to the feet, but this one seems to. And that's really good because this is pretty safe to just throw out. And it's, like, it gives the opponent a lot of time to commit to something, but that thing that they commit to probably won't hit Bison because this is such a recessed attack. And then you can combo into, like, medium scissor from here, I thought. Maybe light scissor, I guess. And that's usually at a spaced range. If you do it from like the max range like that, you'll leave yourself at a range where light scissor is safe. So it ends up being like super solid. And you're usually at a range where you can do it again. So it ends up being really good. I think that gets a net pushback of just a little bit. So you can do a few in a row. It's worth noting this move is pretty slow though. I think it's like seven or eight frames startup. It's like not that fast. V-frame says seven. And it's minus two on block, which is pretty much irrelevant from that far away. Light Scissors is the worst on block, but it's, you know, if it's the only one that combos, it's still the one you want to do. And it's from that range, it'll be space, so even if it's minus four, even if it's blocked and it's minus four, usually alright. Unless you're fighting a character with, like, a really good, like, Laura Super, basically. Something four frames that goes really far. Let's see here. I don't have that much to say about crouch medium kick. It pretty much only used for like just a safe poke that cancels. And it is a low, so you know, if the opponent's not protecting their toes, this is a pretty good way to hit them. Standard hard punch goes the farthest of like any cancel in the whole game, which is kind of neat. The frame data is not that good on it. It's like minus, I think. Minus 3, minus 2, something like that. Minus 6. Ooh, minus 1 on hit. But however minus it is doesn't really matter that much because you can just cancel it to hard scissor. And hard scissor is minus 2. So basically the stand fierce is effectively minus 2 plus those chip damage. That's like a really good little sequence because I'm pretty sure it's a true block string. And it does really nice damage. And it has really good conversions if you have V-trigger. But just that cancel goes insanely far. That's like a really huge range cancel. It's very rare. There's not that much like that in this game. So it's kind of interesting. An interesting little tool that Bison has. And it's the only way to combo into his hard scissor kick, which is important for a lot of his V-trigger combos. That's why Sand Fierce is important for that combo. I'll get to that, though. Let's see here. That's pretty much the main use of Stand Fierce. It's just the empty cancel it with like Hard Scissor from really far out. Use it as a poke. And if it ever hits, you get the cancels to Hard Scissor, which work even if you're hitting extended limbs. Really cool. Let's see. Crouch Fierce is your anti-air. You've got a couple things that are okay anti-airs with Bison, namely Super in this button. This is your absolute most reliable one. It is a bit funky because it does move him forward just a little bit, so you need to do it really early in order to have that not be a problem. But it's okay to do it really early because it's also insanely tall. But pretty much you want to do this button almost as soon as you see a jump. Is this my jumping Ryu? Da-da-da. Yeah. It's so tall, I just got the counter hit like super easily there. But even if you don't get the counter hit, it typically wins clean. I just got a trade there, so, you know, maybe not. But do it early and you won't even have to worry about stuff like that. And it anti-airs even from pretty close, which it normally... Like, if you do it late here, this is the range where it's really problematic. If you do it late from a range like that, you'll fail to hit the opponent at all. Which is awful for Bison. But if you just do it really fast, then you can circumvent that problem. There you go. Just react quickly. And then that becomes a great anti-air from a bunch of different ranges. But it's like his main anti-air normal, and it is pretty reliable at hitting the opponent out of the air. So, you know, a lot better than Crouch Fierce in Street Fighter 4 anyway. That button was awful. It doesn't have much use beyond sniping people out of the air, so just focus on it for that. Stand Hard Kick, super good button. It's plus on block. If you can ever get your opponent to block it, it's fantastic. I showed that deep cross-up combo you can do, but it also combos easily from, like, hard normals. And that's, like, the path to his max damage. So, like, if you're comboing from, like, if you jump over a fireball, that would be, like, your go-to. So jumping hard normal, hard kick, low strong, into medium inferno. Let's see here. It's really plus on block, so you can get frame traps afterwards with, like, certain normals. Like, we'll tend to counter hit their normals. I think low strong is the one you normally go for, and that's the one that also combos on hit, so easy to remember. But that's like plus 3, right? Stand hard kick. Someone just said in the chat plus 3. Yeah, V-frame says plus 3 as well. So that's like one of the most plus attacks in the game that I'm aware of, not counting like jump-ins and stuff. So anytime you get the opponent to block that, you're in a pretty situation. Like, into low strong, that's a 3-frame window that the opponent can hit something, and a lot of characters don't even have a 3-frame normal, and the ones that do, if they can even hit Bison with their 3-frame normal at that range after a stand hard kick, like, even if there is a trade, the low strong's gonna be doing crazy damage during the trade. Crazy more damage than the light normal anyway. So pretty much you've only got invincible moves to try and counter hit that. It's basically just like a really good sequence. And it's like your max damage confirm as well. Let's see here. Crouch Hard Kick is not as good as it was in Street Fighter 4. It can be safe if you hit just the toes, but the range at which that works is very precise in this game. And if you whiff it, it's pretty punishable. And if you get it closer than, like, the max range, then it's also punishable. So getting that toe connect is really hard. But it's worth noting that you can also cancel it to V-trigger, And that's, I'm pretty sure that's plus. That's like not only safe, it's plus. And it's like a safe little, it's a little low poke. But that sweep is like ridiculously slow. So you can't like follow a jump with it or anything. But like that's safe, and if it hits, it gets you like a little bit of oki, and if it's blocked, it gets you pressure. So it ends up being like a nice little way to activate, but Bison can do better. But it's important to note that works. That's the normals. Let's talk about the command normals. I'm pretty sure that's just the down towards fierce, right? And the target combo. I haven't really fucked around with the target combo much. I know that it exists. There's the target. There's the command normal. It's down towards fierce. The startup is pretty abysmal. The range is great. It is a crush counter normal, and it's also pretty plus on block. It's like a plus one, and it's plus six on hit. So again, this is a normal you can follow up with low strong into Inferno. Those are your, the big three is stand strong, stand run house, and down towards fierce. So this automatically hit confirms the down strong, and again you can charge. Like you have to do down towards to do this move, but you can shift to down back immediately, and get charged by the time you need it. It's super good meaty. Stand hard kick is also super good meaty, so it's not a huge distinction. This works from a little farther out though, and it has a big step in, which is important for his combos that I'll show later. And in general, like it's plus on block, so if you do like a lot normal afterwards, it'll beat whatever they do. So it's like a nice little normal to like bait the opponent to push a button, and then you can go for something like that on block, and on hit you would just do the low strong into Inferno or something like that. Very good normal. Stand strong, down towards fierce, the target combo. I haven't really mucked around with this that much. Apparently there's a range where you can connect it where it actually combos. Or something. What's up with that? Someone told me about that. Time. Oh, there it is. I just got it. As long as you don't hit on the first frame with the stand strong, it's a combo. But it's like amazingly precise. And it's as plus as the down towards fierce is, so you can still combo like low strong from it. And it also counter hits people trying to hit buttons after blocking a stand strong. But it's pretty minus on block. It's not like the down towards fierce by itself is plus one, but that is minus five. And you're in range where like Ryu would probably be able to get a low strong on you, so it's like I'm not really certain. I've heard Bison say this is a really good thing, but I haven't seen anything to convince me it's really good. But I would believe that there's some setup where it's incredible. Yeah, meaty it's okay, but even then it's unsafe on block. So even if it combos, if you do it meaty, like, you know, what if they just block? It's kind of a weird move. Let's see here. I don't have anything else to say about that. Let's talk air normals. Jump jab is his best hope at an instant air attack that hits close anti-airs. If the opponent's jumping from this far away, Bison has no hope of an anti-air no matter how early he hits Crouch Fierce. But he can still anti-air these jumps. He has to do like a jump back jab is the most reliable. Like that. You can do jump up jab too, but sometimes Bison will jump like facing the wrong way. Like if you're really close, which is kind of bad. Like that. Tried to intentionally demonstrate it. So jump back jab is a bit more reliable. And jump back jab will, even from like super late jumps, you can just react to a jump from that close and anti-air it. A lot of people are not anti-airing those kinds of jumps. So that's what jump jab really serves. Jump short is pretty much the same thing, but I find jab to be a slightly better hitbox for that kind of thing. Jump strong, I want to show this off on the jumping opponent. There's a little target combo associated with that, hell attack. If you get just one, it's a juggle state. It's a free juggle state, and you can do some kind of neat things there. But you can also do two of them, and that's still a juggle state. And from those, you can get like kind of neat juggles. Like I think that got worse. I think they nerfed that on release, but you can still do the blast. That's like a nice little confirm you can get. That's like the normal conversion, I think. I think there's some resets you can do here, but I don't know what the resets are in this game. You have to do one to do a reset. See, like, there might be like some kind of sneaky dash under or something like that from one of his buttons, but I don't know which ones. It's probably some kind of cool thing you can do. But like that conversion is pretty normal. If you want, oh, does that work? I think I tried that. Yeah, forgot about that. If you can land conversion, conversion's got a bit of slow startup, but if you can land conversion, it's much more rewarding, and also it can go under like that. Hard inferno is the one. Did I say land hard conversion? Hard inferno is the one you want to land, but that one has the most forward movement, so it's kind of it can randomly fail depending on like angles and stuff. So I would say blast is the most reliable, but that's the one you kind of want to land if you can. Super is a really good conversion. Works really reliably. I think I might have lost some hits there. 169 is the damage I did. Ta-ta. No, same damage. Probably does relatively similar damage no matter how you land it. But super is like a really good conversion there. In general, this is really good for catching people if you see them in an air-to-air situation. Most air-to-airs only do like 90 or 100, but Bison gets a knockdown plus like 170 damage. That's pretty nice. Jump forward is his cross-up. It's actually bigger behind him than in front of him, which is kind of rare for a cross-up. The only one I can think of besides that is Gen's. So you can cross-up from pretty alarmingly close, like just because of how big the normal is. I'm doing it kind of early. No, never mind. Maybe not that big. Maybe I'm trying to show off a little too much. But you can, even with Bison's floaty-ass jump, you can get some. You can hit decently behind him and pick up Ryu. I'm like trying to find the max range. It's not as big as I wanted it to be. Not as big as the animation, anyway. You do kind of have to read for the air-to-air. Let's actually talk about that really fast. Most people don't hit buttons like this because it prevents them from hitting the opponent if they don't jump. Most people wait until they get low enough that their air attack will hit a grounded opponent. It's very rare to see someone doing like that. That doesn't do anything. That's not good. If Bison sees an opponent jumping towards him and he's waiting and watching for it, and you jump up and do like instant strong, I guarantee you 90% of the time, they're not going to be able to react to that. No, like 100% of the time. That's like ridiculously hard to react to, that Bison suddenly jumping up towards you with the hell attack. And they're not going to be able to hit a button fast enough that they can hit Bison out of it. And they're not the only way they beat it is preemptively doing buttons like that, which won't even hit a grounded opponent, so no one ever does it. So if you see like a character, I do this all the time when I'm playing Bison, is I watch for someone to jump towards me, and then I just jump towards strong, and it like counter hits whatever they were gonna do. I have like crazy good success with that. Trust me, it's like way better than it sounds. It's just anti-air with jumps, anti-air with jump attacks, and it's also more damaging than his crouch fierce. So like you know, it's a lot better than people give it credit for. But if they're predicting you to do, like, instant air hell attack, they can beat it. Just because they're in the air already, they can resolve their jumping attack startup already. So, like, if they know you're going to do that, they can just attack early. But the point is, attacking early also, like, makes you lose to a Bison who just stays on the ground. So, like, it's... Even if they can punish it... And they can't punish this at all. This is just a clean anti-air. But they have to take a risk to punish that. But they can punish it. Anyway, jump forward is a cross-up. The hit stun is not as good as his jumping hard normals, so it's more consistent to go to stand strong, as I mentioned. That's like his bread and butter there. You can go for a hard kick if you're jumping over Ryu and Ryu does like a fireball or something like that. You can, with precise timing, get that combo. So if, you know, if you see that you're going to get a punish, it's good. Bison's jump hell attack is a bit further than Ryu's jump medium punch, but that still works for Ryu's jump medium punch. But like Bison's has more reach, which is a bit better. Jump hard punch and jump hard kick, pretty much interchangeable. Jump hard punch has a bit of a smaller hurt box, so it is a bit better. It goes really far down at an angle, so like it can beat some anti-air normals, or at least trade with them, which is good for Bison. Like a lot of anti-air normals that are semi-reliable, this is the kind of normal which gives them trouble. Hard kick is a bit further lateral range, and I think jump hard punch is a bit further vertical range. So pretty much whichever one you want to use, use that one. They're pretty interchangeable. Let's see here. That's pretty much all his air normals, right? Yeah, you can delay the second hell attack as long as the first hell attack connects. You can't just whiff hell attack in this game. You used to be able to do both hits all the time. But now if you whiff the first hit, the second it doesn't come out. It used to be that you could do jump early one to hit an airborne opponent if there was one. And then if they didn't jump, there was no airborne opponent, you could just do the second one on like normal timing for a jump in and just get a normal jump in. but now you can't do that anymore. It was kind of a stupid option select anyway. It wasn't even that helpful. I guess that's it for normals, right? I can't think of any other normals I haven't talked about. Special moves, I have a lot to say here. Psychoblast, it's safe. It's like minus one. And it's minus four for the light one, but the pushback is so good that no one's ever going to punish that. The medium one is minus one. The hard one is minus, or it's plus two. All of those frames on all of them are pretty pointless because it's pretty much a reset situation every time the opponent blocks it. Because it leaves them so far out. Like, this is, like, the relative frames of the attack are pretty irrelevant from this far out. I just talked about jump heavy normals, holy fuck. The hard one comes out significantly slower, but it does have the best frame advantage on block. They all do the same damage, I think, which is 60, I think. 70. Maybe they don't all do the same damage. No, they all do 70. Okay. That's pretty low for a special move, especially like the hard version. Like, it's really low for a hard version of a special move. But the point of this move is there's virtually no commit and virtually no risk. It's like a nearly completely safe move. It destroys fireballs. It is a fireball, so you can, if the opponent throws a Hadouken, you can nullify it with that, which builds you a little bit of bar. It's not that bad. And it also doesn't tend to trade because it's a fireball. So if you're, like, fighting a character, it's very riskless to do something like this against a lot of opponents. It's really difficult to stop Bison from doing this. And if you try and poke and trade with it, Bison will usually win clean. So this is a really obnoxious button against grapplers or stuff. Like, it's really difficult for them to contend with that. And they can jump, like trying to jump over it, but you can just anti-air them if you're not, you know, doing the Psychoblast. So it ends up being pretty annoying to deal with for, like, half the cast. The EX one is a fireball. It explodes once it gets near the opponent. Even if they jump, it'll just explode under them. But they can jump over it without too much trouble. It's kind of... It's mostly useful for, like, EX, for, like, V-trigger combos. It's not really... You can do it and then follow it in, because it's pretty slow. Like, you can... It's really scary for the opponent to try and hit Bison during stuff like that. But, like, you can get some shenanigans, like jumping over the opponent's head, then they have to block the fireball the other way, or, like, stuff like that. You can follow it in and get a little bit of pressure. Like, that would hit... The opponent would have to block the other way in order to get that. It's kind of tricky, but only if the opponent actually gives you that much time. I think it absorbs two projectiles. So, like, if you throw it and the opponent does a Hadouken, I think it won't destroy Bison's fireball. But I don't want to say that for sure. Now, the explosion happens whenever it hits the opponent either. If Ryu neutral jumps over that, it explodes under him. It, like, detects where the opponent is by vertical range, but not horizontal range. Or horizontal, but not vertical, rather. Anyway. Fuck. Let's see here. I'm pretty sure about that. I don't really have that much to say about the EX one. I don't know what it's all for, besides following in and pressure. Double knee press. I would call this, like, Bison's entire gameplay in the move. Double knee press is two hits of block damage. The damage is not so hot, but it's not about the damage. It's about the block damage. It's about the attrition. It's about controlling space and spamming moves. All scissor kicks can be unsafe in very specific scenarios. The hard one is only punishable by Geef Super, and even then you can kind of space it to not be punishable by Geef Super. Maybe, I don't know. It's hard to space the hard one. It's really easy to space the light one, and it's kind of easy to space the medium one. Generally, the scissor kicks... Generally, you just want to go... Like, the scissor kicks are generally safe, depending on how you land them. Like, the light one point-blank might be unsafe for, like, the whole cast. But, like, generally, if you do, like, a string like, that... I'm trying to intentionally have it be blocked. I just got it to combo. That's not point-blank enough that most characters can get it punished. Most light normals won't hit from this range. So that's just safe, even if they block it. And after they block it, like... your light normal might not even hit, and if you whiff a light normal, Bison can, like, hit you out of your light normal with a medium normal. Or, like, he can watch for you to do a button. He can, if you do a medium normal and he does a light normal, he can maybe, like, counter hit you and then go into another scissor kick from there. So, like, combos like, stuff like that is, like, kind of good pressure. And in general, Bison can very rapidly, through, like, repeated scissor kicks, get a shit ton of chip on the opponent and a shit ton of block damage. So, like, let me show Ryu's health after, like, three. I thought that would be in range. Like, look at that. After three scissor kicks, I've just lost, like, a ton of health as Ryu. So really, like, Bison's strat is to get the opponent to block a lot of scissor kicks and then, like, get scared, basically. Bison's strat is to worry the opponent that the damage is racking up and force them to make, like, reads, make commits to try and beat them. So, like, it's really common as Bison to do, like, stuff like this and just get, like, a bunch of block damage, and if the opponent tries to hit a button to hit Bison out of it, like, basically you're trying to press the opponent's desperation. You don't have to use hard kick kicks. It just depends on the spacing and the safety. Like, don't go thinking that light and medium scissor kick are useless. They're arguably more useful. The hard kick one is really slow. It's just a matter of spacing. Like, if you do, like, a light kick scissor kick like this, there's nothing in the game that'll punish it except maybe, like, Laura super. Or, like, maybe, like, other 4-frame supers. There's no light normal that'll go that far. And if they try and do a light normal, if they think that it's a range where it's punishable, like, let's say, like, this. This is, like, they can hit a light normal pretty safely there. But, like, if they hit a light normal from here, you can hit them out of their light normal with, like, no trouble. Like, hard kick is slow and safe, but, like, the light ones are really good for trying to convince the opponent to hit normals. The opponent is very incentivized to do a light normal following blocking a scissor kick. But, what are you talking about? Light kick Tatsu? That's not going to punish. The opponent is very incentivized because Bison can't preempt a light normal, but if you do a light normal that's not going to hit, Bison can just whack you out of it with, like, a stand medium kick or something like that. This is really difficult for, like, to apply some counter pressure. And you can beat the stand medium kick if you do, like, let's say Ryu does his stand medium kick at the same time. Ken's, like, Tatsu is only 3 frames if it hits point blank. You guys literally don't know what you're talking about. It's not a punish. It's only a punish if it's point blank. Shut the fuck up. Light scissor kick is safe at almost all ranges. Have you ever fought a Bison? It's only unsafe if you do it absolutely point blank. Ken's is only 3 frames if it hits in the first frame, and in order to hit in the first frame, you have to hit on the way up. Like, with the spacing, it's almost impossible to punish. Everyone literally shut up. I'm, like, tired of reading this. And even then, if you're doing, like, the medium one from, like, various attacks, that's even more obnoxious because it's -3 and some characters can't punish that at all. And, like, hard scissor. Unfortunately, hard scissor doesn't combo from a lot of stuff, but you can still... It's hard to distinguish them from close range. You can usually spot the light one because it kind of leaves you spaced, but medium and hard are very hard to tell apart. There are some moves that will kind of blow this up as long as they can hit that close on their first frame. But, like, even Ryu's light uppercut, which is 3 frame startup, like, that's not gonna punish, I don't think that'll hit on its first frame from Ryu. We can, like, test it though. But I'd need to, like, have two controllers and go at it. I think Ken's hard uppercut will no. They slowed that down, didn't they? I think that's 5 frames now. Ken's hard uppercut during the beta was 3 frames, and you could punish Bison scissor kicks like that, but now it's slower. But, like, watch any Bison play, and there's, like, a lot of scissor kicks. Scissor kick spam is really common in this matchup. Let me see here. I got completely distracted. EX scissor kick is, I think, -1. It's either -1 or +1. I'm pretty sure it's -1. And it's also pretty rewarding on hit. It's, 150 damage, 200 stun. So it's not terribly risky to throw out. And if you manage to get a hit, it does a lot of damage. So, like, that ends up being, like, super good. 4 frames for Ken's hard uppercut? We sure about that? I'm actually going to double check because that's important. That's important in this matchup. That's still okay because if we do, like, a medium scissor kick, Ken can't easily distinguish the light and the medium, and the hard uppercut only punishes the light. Yeah, all 4. Interesting. It's not a big deal, but, like, that you have to be wary of characters that have really big attacks that go that far. So Ken would be a matchup where you'd probably... This is another thing. If you're fighting, like, a character with, like, a... I don't know. Something that can get a punish. Like, let's say Zangief with his super can get a punish on a lot of scissor kicks. You would end with Blast. Blast would leave you at a range where those kind of punishes wouldn't work. And maybe against Ken, you would end in Blast. Having fought, like, Chun-Li a lot as Bison as well, and, you know, having fought a lot of Bisons as Chun-Li, Chun-Li's crutch light kick can generally punish, like, a lighter or medium scissor kick. And you can't get anything from Chun-Li's crouch leg kick at a range, but it does punish. So like if you're fighting Chun-Li, you might want to end with blasts on her as well. Let's see. But it's like it's a decision you want to make in like every matchup, whether you want to end in blasts or end in scissor kicks. The scissor kicks go a little further and do a little bit more damage, I think. And they also leave the opponent standing, which can be good or not, depending on the matchup. I got so distracted there. Where's Bison's frame data at? What's the next move? Stomp, I guess, and Devil's Reverse and Inferno. Stomp is a bit weird. This is a very weird special move. Bison tracks you and lands on your head. You can anti-air it with a really good anti-air if it's like invincible. That'll be on YouTube, yeah. If it's not invincible, the stomp will generally win, but not always. It's like decently reliable. But it's all based on relative timing. If the opponent reacts to the fact that you're stomping, he can jump forward on reaction to your stomp and hit Bison out of the air. But this is safe on block, and you can also use it to some degree to, like, you know, escape the corner maybe. A lot of characters can punish that. And you can also use it to just annoy with chip damage from really far out. Yeah, Ryu's uppercut, I've seen that. I've had that happen to me. Goes under stomp. Ryu's EX uppercut beats it, though. It really depends on the normal or the special move. It depends on the anti-air, what works and what doesn't. So as Bison, you pretty much need to stomp on a bunch of people and see what they can do about it. But everyone can beat it by jumping in. If they do a forward dash or a back dash or a walk forward from very early, they can make the stomp whiff and then hit it on the ground. But that's usually something that's kind of hard to react to. And also, the stomp looks kind of like a jump. So like if Bison does a normal jump and you try and walk forward, you're gonna eat a cross up and eat all kinds of damage. I think Birdie's crouch medium punch beats the stomp, but I'm not 100% sure. But as Birdie, I usually just do like a jump, neutral jump attack, neutral jump hard kick. The EX one does a lot more damage and also has a cool follow-up hit. And also, it's kind of hard to demonstrate because there aren't that many moves that give you that much oki, but you can OTG with this. I don't know, like, it might only be in V trigger. It hits opponents on the ground. I don't, like, know a situation where you can do that anymore. There you go. There's an example of one. Stomps and EX stomps can OTG, but, like, if the opponent quickstands, the opportunity to OTG goes away. So that's, like, not a combo. Or it is a combo if they don't quickstand, but they can quickstand to get out of it. So it's like not, it's not, it's hard to actually land on a good opponent. And also there are very few knockdowns that give you enough time to get it. And I don't know what the knockdowns are, if they even exist. From the stomp, you can also do a Devil's Reverse, which is just punch during the animation. This is really good because it beats a lot of things that beat the stomp. Like if I'm Birdie and I'm trying to do low strong, let's say it does beat the stomp, I'm still not 100% sure. If Birdie does low strong, that'll whiff punish the low strong. So it's kind of a situational, or like if I'm fighting a Ryu and he like tries to uppercut, that'll probably hit the uppercut. If he does medium uppercut, like the invincibility period will probably end, and then I'll hit him out of the recovery with the punch. So it's like a little way to make Bison a little bit safer. Yeah, it is kind of like a Vampire Savior OTG, isn't it? The EX one, you can still do the Devil's Reverse. But the EX, it's not like an EX Devil's Reverse. Basically, the Devil's Reverse is treated like a special move. If you do the EX Stomp into a Devil's Reverse, it's in the normal Devil's Reverse. And if you do a normal Stomp, you can still EX Devil's Reverse it. Or you can burn two separate bars to do an EX Stomp into an EX Devil's Reverse, but why would you? That actually only seemed to consume one bar. So I take it back. If you're going to do EX Devil's Reverse anyway, maybe do it from an EX Stomp. I don't know. EX Devil's Reverse is a lot more reliable at beating at counterpoking stuff because he goes up a lot higher, so you're less likely to get hit. And he also falls a lot faster, so you're still likely to pick up the punish. Like, Stomp into EX Devil's Reverse will, like, reliably beat a, like an anti-air uppercut from Ryu. And there's a pretty good chance that it'll beat a, like a jump in strong from Ryu. Like, that'll probably, like, counter-hit Ryu. You'll probably avoid the hit. This got invincibility when you do EX Devil's Reverse. So as soon as Bison hits the EX move, Ryu's jump strong will probably whiff, and then Bison will probably land on Ryu with the 140 damage or whatever. So that ends up being pretty good. And Devil's Reverse is, I think, plus, right? God. Bison, work with me. I think it works pretty much like a normal jump in on block. Causes a knockdown on hit. I don't think you can juggle anything there, but now's a great time to find out. No, that'd be kind of cool. EX Head Stomp, for example, can V-skill under it. You can use EX Devil's Reverse to punish. Yeah, it's really good for picking up, like saving yourself. It makes it a lot less risky. EX Stomp actually has invincibility until he leaves the ground. It doesn't hit that fast, but it is invincible until he gets off the floor, which means that if you're really desperate for a way out, that's the closest thing Bison has to invincibility, barring super. So if the opponent's pressuring you, you can do an EX Stomp, and if you do get hit, you'll get hit out of the air. But if you don't get hit, you might be able to get them to block an EX Stomp and get out of the corner, or like block an EX Stomp and get full screen or something like that. EX Stomp is safe. Yeah. I should show that off. If you get Devil's Reverse on a jumping opponent, which isn't even that rare, you can get a juggle afterwards. Nice juggle. This might take a few attempts. Let me do it from further away where it's more consistent. That was probably it, but I didn't charge. Oh, that was so low. What do you even do there? Inferno? That doesn't look good. Super, maybe. Looks like you need a corner. Yeah, I don't know. I've never really experimented with that kind of follow-up. Let me see. Maybe just scissor kick if you get like a really high connect. Inferno, I guess we can talk about. Inferno used to be a charge move and it was safe, but now it's not. It's just quarter circle back punch. And it's pretty minus. Like, you can go for punishes pretty reliably on it. It's, like, minus quite a lot. It's really hard to space it to make it safe. Some characters do have a little bit of trouble punishing it. I can say as Laura, like, oftentimes I feel like my only punish is, like, a light elbow or, like, stand forward. Things that aren't super rewarding. I'm not even sure if light elbow would punish if it was blocked. If it whiffed, I'd be able to punish it like that. But I'm not sure that it starts in the appropriate 10 frames that I need. But it's mostly a combo ender. And it does do some kind of interesting things if you, during some juggles, I should say. Like, you can juggle into it, and in V-Trigger, you can juggle out of it. The light one is the fastest, but it still doesn't combo from lights. The low strong is, I mean, the strong one is the one that combos from mediums, and the light one, even though it combos from mediums, you might as well do the strong one. Like, it does a bit more damage. The hard one does the most damage, but you can only combo it from the stand fierce. And instead of doing stand fierce into hard inferno, you'd rather do stand hard kick into low strong into medium inferno. You'd rather do a link combo. So it's like his general combo ender, usually the medium one. You can also do the X one, which does a lot more damage, and the X one is actually safe. That's important to note. Is that if you're not really sure if you're going to be blocked or not, you can just do medium, like EX Inferno, and that's only minus one. It does pretty good chip damage too. It also, I think, genuinely hits on both sides instead of only appearing to, so you can use it a bit as an anti-cross-up. I'm not going to say do this, I'm not going to say it's good, but I'm going to say I've fucked around with it and had success. So, like, be aware that that's an option that Bison has. Let's see here. It's not invincible though, so if you do it too late, or like if they have a hitbox on a jumping cross up that's really good, it'll still like trade or even beat you. And the trade is really awful because you only get some of the Inferno, I think. That's all special moves. I've got a lot to say about his V trigger because it changes all special moves quite a lot. I'll talk about how to beat Bison at the end of this, I think. That's a good thing to bring up. I need to be more aware of that. Bison's V skill is like a parry. At first I thought you could only absorb fireballs, but you can actually absorb limbs too. I've had pretty good success parrying with it, like against Dalsim a lot of the time. I did like a long set Bison versus Dalsim, and I was like, sometimes I would just periodically do that on when I expected a limb to be coming. Like immediately after I blocked the stand strong, I'd anticipate another stand strong, and I'd try and snatch the limb. And anytime you successfully snatch something, you can throw a fireball back, and the fireball's like two hits and comes out really quickly. So it's like a parry and counter kind of move. And it generally it's used to snatch up fireballs. Bison's biggest weakness in I talked about jump strong. Watch the archive or something, I don't know. Really, Bison's biggest weakness in Street Fighter 4 was that he didn't handle slow creeping projectiles very well at all. but now he actually has a really good response to slow creeping projectiles. You can just snatch them up, which is really good against slow fireballs, because even if Nash throws a hard fireball and follows it in, there's very little he can do. That's like the most extreme example. There's very little he can do to prevent you from just snatching the fireball. But against like fast fireballs like this, you can snatch it and throw another fireball back, and Ryu has a really hard time preventing you from doing that. And even if he like predicts you to throw the fireball back and tries to jump over it, you could just snatch the fireball and then immediately anti-air. So like, it's not even a reliable counter to jump in afterwards or anything like that. But in general, this just it builds Bison some V-meter every single time he absorbs something, limb or fireball. And anytime he successfully absorbs something, he can do that. He can tap it again, or hold it. Yeah, hold it. Double tap or hold. And throw a fireball back. And from up close, that's actually like a punish. See that, like, hit Ryu before he could start blocking again. And that's what it'll do usually against pokes. And it's good as a situational counter for a lot of stuff. Last time I mentioned with Ryu's parry, you could do like you could counter like a Geef Stand Fierce. You could do that with this too. If you saw Geef charging Stand Fierce and you like blocked until it was max charge, you could absorb the max charge with the V skill and then like get a punish. It doesn't have a hitbox though, so if you're, it doesn't have a function unless the opponent's hitting a button. Yeah, Ryu actually can, if from far away, Ryu can parry the fireball that you toss back at him. But if he throws a fireball, like, it's really common for Ryu to throw a fireball and then throw another fireball, like, as soon as you block the first one. And if you snatch and throw back the first fireball, he'll throw another fireball. The one you throw back will go through his and hit him. Because the Bison's fireball that he throws back is actually, like, a two-hit fireball. So, like, it'll blow through normal fireballs. So it really helps him just win fireball wars really easily. I shouldn't say really easily, because he has to be kind of precise in absorbing the fireball. The timing is a little bit tight. And if it's a slow fireball, the opponent can potentially follow it in and give him problems. Like, let's say I'm Nash, and I throw a fireball. If I'm pretty sure Bison's about to absorb, I can do, like, the flip kick, the moonsault kick in. And if he just blocks, the fireball's going to make my flip... Or he can't hit a button to anti-air my flip kick because the fireball's going to hit him out of it, and he can't absorb the fireball because my flip kick's going to hit the absorb. What do you call that? The moonsault kick. So there are ways to prevent Bison from really just using this to completely shut down fireball wars, but it is pretty good. And also, it's worth noting that like the closer you are, the better it is. I'll probably do a how-to for every character in the game. What was I going to say here? That's pretty much it for his V skill. That's not a whole lot to say. It's just like a weird kind of projectile parry. It's like a semi-parry, semi-projectile counter. Oh yeah, even if Ryu parries it, like, Bison's safe, so there's no like follow-up and punish or anything like that. V trigger, I guess. Someone said you didn't need charge if you were in V trigger, but now I've tested it and determined that you do in fact need charge in V trigger. That's my first time testing it. You don't need charge for the EX follow-ups to moves. Alright, let's talk about Bison's V-trigger for a second. Pretty much, his forward dash becomes the best forward dash in the game by a pretty generous margin. He becomes invincible much sooner and for much longer. So, like, dashing through fireballs becomes really easy, dashing through limbs becomes really easy. I think he also travels a bit farther. Like, two forward dashes will just get you in, like that. He travels, like 50-60% of the screen per dash. The charge just feels like a normal charge. It feels, like, not any different from what the normal charge time is. Anyway. Oh, hold on, is that it? When canceling a normal into a special. Yeah, that might be it. There we go. Someone knew. Someone in the chat knew. That's why someone said it. If you're canceling, then you don't need charge. You only need charge raw. That's really neat. Thanks for that info. That's actually really good, too, because it's really easy to do, like, walk back. If you don't have charge, like, you know, do, like, towards light kick or medium kick, like, block and then towards, like, walk in, medium kick, something like that. It'd be really easy to get scissor kicks on accident. But, you're not worried about that in a cancel scenario. That's really neat. No, that's one of many reasons that Bison is OP as fucking V-trigger. Charge time is usually not that bad in this game, though, so it's not... That's less of a big factor than you would think, but it's also really nice. Let me see here. Oh god, my alarm's going off. Bison V-Trigger changes the property of all special moves, All the Infernos are combined into one Inferno. Like, the versions are no longer different. It comes out really fast. It comes out as fast as, like, the light one used to. They all do 130 damage, 100 stun. And they all launch a bit higher, so you can do a little bit... You can do some juggles that you couldn't normally do. That's, like, the main one. I did it a little too fast. There you go. So, like, anytime you get a combo, that's, like, a really good one-bar follow-up. Ends up doing a ton of damage. So, like, the launch is a little bit higher. The blast becomes better. It, like, comes out faster. I think it does a smidge more damage. 100 instead of 70-100. And I think it leaves a little farther out, and I think it's safer. And it definitely comes out faster. Or at least as fast as the light one. All of his moves, I think it's plus two. All of the moves become, like, the best of all worlds for the V-Trigger. The only special moves that even seem to still have, like, different versions are the scissor kicks. And the scissor kicks are actually pretty crazy, but we'll get to them. Stomp does a lot more damage and knocks down. Dash scissors. I can't get dash scissors to work like that. The comm will occasionally just do dash in scissors, but, like, we don't know how. I think it's just the fact that it's the comm. His EX moves all become a lot better. I'll do a lot more damage and stuff. Like that. This does a shit ton. There's his EX Devil's Reverse. His Devil's Reverse turns invisible, and while it's invisible, it's invulnerable. So, like, that's really good at beating an uppercut, because the uppercut won't even get near him. He'll just hit it from behind. It's also a cross-up to block, so, you know. A little bit trickier to anti-air, a little bit trickier to defend yourself against. And it does have true invincibility for a little bit. What else? What changes? There's, like, a couple other random things. That looks so cool. I love the noises it makes when he teleports. The forward dash is, like, the main change, and he can forward dash shoot people now. Yeah, it always crosses up, I'm pretty sure. I'm not aware of a way to make it not cross up. Maybe from, like, really far out, it wouldn't cross up. You can't even get it out that close. How do you choose sides? That was after I left V-Trigger. I can't even get it out until I'm close enough. Holding back doesn't seem to do anything. Holding forward doesn't seem to do anything. Only in corners, I guess, you don't change sides. In V-Trigger, it always crosses up. Okay, confirming what I thought. Let's see here. What else? Scissor kick is weird as hell. If you're doing scissor kick, the light scissor kick actually slows down. The light kick becomes the speed of a medium one. The medium one becomes the speed of a hard one. And the hard one becomes even slower. Like, normally you can do low strong into medium scissor kick. That doesn't work anymore. And now you can only do low strong into light scissor kick, whereas it normally goes into light or medium. Normally you can do stand fierce into hard scissor kick. My trigger ran out. That doesn't work anymore, but you can do stand fierce into medium. There doesn't appear to be a way to combo into the hard one at all, but the hard one is super, super good. I think they get much better frames in V-Trigger, but they compensate by having much worse startup. Let me see here. And this is where things get really nuts. Any special move, you can cancel into a different special move's EX version. So, like, I can't do Blast into EX Blast. I just got a crazy input overlap there. But I can do Blast into EX Inferno. Or, like, Blast into EX Scissor Kick, or something like that. Nice. Yeah, I can set V-Timer to infinite. I just haven't yet. Bad execution. There you go. Or you can do, like, from Inferno, you can do, like, EX Fireball. Or, like, EX Fireball, EX Inferno, or something like that. That used to work in beta, I think, but it doesn't seem to work anymore. Yeah, Bison's dash and V trigger goes through. Bison's normal forward dash doesn't go through. I'm not really sure what the optimal 2-bar combos are anymore, but I still know the optimal 1-bar combos. Okay. This is where V trigger starts being really neat. Let's say I get a combo into medium scissor kick in normal mode. Any time during that scissor kick, I can cancel the V trigger. And I'm plus like 4 or 5 there. I don't know which one, but one of those two. And I can combo a stand short on the V trigger cancel. So like I can put together combos like something like that. That was a one bar plus trigger combo. That's pretty painful. EX Inferno, EX Stomp. All right, let me try that. Yeah, there you go. That seems like an optimal two-bar combo. You can't dash through point blank unless you're in V-trigger. I guarantee it. Stop making corrections with things that aren't true. Let's see here. Crouch strong doesn't work after medium scissor. Fuck. That's important. A lot of people don't know how this works, so let's make it clear right now. If you do hard scissor, you have enough time to combo crouch strong. If you do medium or light scissor, you don't. So you need hard scissor in order to do those kinds of combos, in order to get the crouch medium punch and get the optimal stuff from there. So like his optimal two bar combo, you wouldn't do that link, like the stand hard kick low strong, because that prevents you from using hard scissor kick, which you need to do the higher damage combos. So you would do stand fierce instead into hard scissor, and then from there you can do low strong, and then from there I guess you would do light scissor. I mean, it depends on what you're trying to do. If you wanted a one bar combo, you would do that one. Let's show off the combos in context. That's your one bar combo with Bison for 403. And let's try the. This is going to be pretty scaled, but let's try it anyway. There's a two bar combo. Added 30 extra damage. Even with all the scaling, that was like not terrible use of bar. Pretty interesting. And then if you want a three bar combo, you just do super, so, you know. But Bison can convert like extra bars into damage really easily, like with combos like that. But you've got to be aware that your options are much more limited if you're using medium scissor into V trigger, because then the only thing you can land is like a stand short, and from the stand short you can't do that much. You can't do a scissor kick from stand short because they're too slow. Oh, that was pretty bad. That was even the light scissor kick, and it's too slow. You pretty much got to do blast. That's like the only special move he has that combos, and from blast your options are really limited. You can't do an EX stomp. You can't do an. I think you can do an EX Inferno. No, that doesn't work either. You pretty much got to do EX scissor kick. That's like your only option there. So, like, combos from medium scissor kick are not nearly as rewarding as combos from hard scissor kick if you're going to do V trigger cancels. It's worth noting that scissor kick also cancels to super, but you've got to do a first hit cancel. It used to be that you could cancel the second hit, but not anymore. So you can't just do safe scissor kicks and then react to one working and super. You've got to do the super immediately. You could do like a low strong into scissor kick. Like let's say like something like this. Let's say I do low strong into medium scissor, which is something the Bison does all the time. You can actually react to whether that low strong is hitting or being blocked, and then do a super or not based on whether it's working. Like that's a hit confirm. You could hit confirm super like that, and that's safe, or it's safe against most of the cast. That's minus three. You could to practice that, you could just go like into training mode, set it to random block, and just watch that hit. So I supered. That was blocked, so I didn't super. It's like pretty easy to react. Pretty easy to react. I haven't played online in ranked yet, but I've done a lot of battle lobbies and stuff. Apart from that, super is usually best after an inferno because the entire inferno hits followed by the super, so it's usually that's like how to get the squeeze the most damage out of it. A really high damage Bison combo using super but not V trigger would be something like that. And that ends up doing pretty nice damage. 486. Not the highest in the game, but you know. Is there more to say about V trigger? What haven't I not talked about? This is, I'm not sure. His super is the only thing he has that's invincible. That's really important. That's like a super important thing. I was gonna say super is a good anti-air. Crouch fierce and super is best anti-air. Super actually hits behind him a little bit, so it's really good. Optimal punish. Yes! I can't believe I didn't talk about crush counters. I'm so bad. Thank you for that. I never talked about crush counters at all. Okay, this is important. Stan Harkic is your go-to crush counter just purely because it's a lot faster than out towards Fierce. The damage potential is pretty much identical on them. From Stan Harkic, the optimal follow-up is... Well, actually, I'll get to it. I think what you're intended to do is Stan Harkic down towards Fierce and then low strong Inferno. But you can actually... And if you get the crush counter down towards Fierce, you can do Stan Harkic into low strong Inferno. And I think Stan Harkic and down towards Fierce do exactly the same damage. I think. 96. So it's not super important which one you go for. So, like, you can do... whichever one of those you get with crush counter, you just go into the other one. So, like, if you block a shorty, you can use Stan Harkic down towards strong. I mean, down towards Fierce. Low strong into Inferno. Or if you got, like, a crush counter towards Fierce and you just reacted, you would do, like, Stan Harkic from there into low strong. I guess you have to do a little bit of walking forward for that one. If you get a max range connect, you've got to do a Stan Fierce. And from there, you can do hard scissor. That's, like, his normal scissor kick combo. I mean, his normal crush counter combo. This does a little bit more damage than doing Stan Fierce into hard scissor. But Stan Fierce into hard scissor, again, is how you get your really, really high damage V-trigger combos. Anyway, there's actually a slightly more optimal thing to do there. It's easy to do down towards Fierce after a crush counter, but you can actually do two Stan hard kicks with precise timing. There's like a little bit of walk-in. Like Stan hard kick, slight walk-in, low strong. And I just said that the damage is identical on down towards Fierce and Stan hard kick, but the dizzy is not. That was 180 dizzy, and this is 120. So you can get a lot of extra dizzy for, like, no cost if you do Stand Hard Kick, Walk-In, Stand Hard Kick. I don't think you can do it with no walk-in. Yeah, you need just a little bit. But you've got time. Anyway, you can squeeze a little bit of extra stun. That did 288, 465. Remember that number, 465? 420, there you go. Of course it would be 420. This is an example of, like, a little bit of little bit of min-maxing there. But if you've got the V-trigger and you want to do a V-trigger combo, you go Stand Fierce into Hard Scissor and then combos from that. I freaked out and forgot what to do. Yeah, everyone loves Micro Walk. I'll try one more time. There you go. Pretty cool looking combo. I'm not sure that he can do light scissor kick, V-trigger activate, and then combo a super. That's kind of important. Or medium scissor kick, rather. Like, if you do medium scissor kick activate, and do stand short, I don't know if stand short combos into super from that range. Yeah, it's too far. And then if you do, like, a blast, which is the only other thing that combos, and try and do super from there. Let me try that, actually. Bison, get closer. I think that doesn't work either. So I don't think you can combo a super from the medium scissor kick, or at least not that I'm aware of. Maybe in the corner. But from hard scissor kick, you can do like either Inferno super or scissor kick super, and those should both work. So let's say like that. Oh, wait, hold on. I didn't even mention this. Super can be activated midair. That's almost no one seems to know that, but it's kind of neat. That's not a huge deal, but I think if you did, like, jump in on Ryu, and then, like, Ryu did medium uppercut, and you did super, I think your super would beat his medium uppercut. So you might be able to gimmick people out like that. You might be able to get, like, surprise counters. Yeah, like, a lot of people didn't know that. It's, like, very poorly known. That's not commonly known Bison tech. And also, you can do stomp cancel to super. In V-trigger, anyway. I don't know if it works outside V-trigger. Apparently it doesn't. I'm pretty sure that works. There you go. I thought you could combo it, though. Maybe only on airborne opponents? That window is weird as fuck. Yeah, maybe only on airborne opponents. Oh, there you go. You can combo out of stomp outside of V-trigger. How neat is that? Like, let's say you see a fireball. Ryu throws a fireball under you, and you're like, oh, hey. Oh, hey, Ryu. This motion sometimes not working. I don't understand why. pretty interesting though, right? Very, very, very uncommon that people know about that. I think if you get the stomp, the OTG stomp in V-Trigger, you can get that super cancel as well. It's just kind of neat that that works. There's like, no one knows about that. It's kind of interesting. Oh, yeah, Devil's Reverse. I should have talked about that. That actually just worked on a grounded connect. I guess you'd wait for the grounded connect instead of trying to juggle the super from midair. But it's neat that it works. What about, that was too far when I waited for the ground. Shit. There you go. Looking good. Not bad, right? There's some neat stuff you can do with that anyway. Anyway, super is the only invincible thing he has. This is what I was going to get to. So, when Bison does a move that's minus, he really doesn't have a way of preventing you from doing a, like, an attack afterwards. Like, let's talk about scissor kick. Let's talk about beating Bison just a little bit. If you eat a scissor kick, Bison is either neutral or plus, I think, depending on which version of the scissor kick it is. Checking my secret sources. Double knee press plus 3 for light, plus 2 for medium, plus 1 for hard. So it's actually like the one that's... Oh, it is plus 1 for EX double knee press. So the hard one is the least plus on hit, but light is the most plus on hit. So basically, if you block... If you get hit by a scissor kick, you're pretty fucked. You're in a really bad spot because Bison can immediately follow it up with a block string into another scissor kick. Yes, I mentioned V-Trigger Dash. You really just want to make sure that you actually like start blocking at some point during Bison's pressure. Because once you block a scissor kick is once you can start like getting out, start pressuring. If you get hit by a scissor kick, you're at Bison's mercy, unless you do something invincible, and that's super risky. But if you block a scissor kick, Bison's minus, and the only thing he could do to interrupt your button press is a super. So even if you can't get a punish, you can get a little bit of counter pressure going to push Bison back out or deal a little bit of chip damage back to him. So like it's very common after blocking a scissor kick, like even if it's not at a range where you can punish, to just do like a really fast normal. Like what's a good example of this? What's like a good like stand medium kick that's like 6 frames? Just like a 6 frame button that goes decently far. Like, let's say I was Bison and I did stand strong. If I did stand strong after blocking a Bison, like, medium scissor kick, it would beat anything Bison could do. Because his scissor kick's minus 3 and he doesn't have a 3-frame normal to hit. So, like, if I did my fucking... Is this 6 frames or is it 7? I think it's 7. Let's say low strong. If I pushed that button afterwards, it would beat anything that Bison could go for. And then I could cancel it to, like, push Bison out, depending on whether or not I had a special move. With Bison, I would just do that. Like, that would be good after a... After blocking a scissor kick, I would be able to like get to push Bison away and deal a little bit more chip damage and like pressure my way out. And every character has to do things like that to get counter pressure on Bison, to escape repeated scissor kick pressure. A lot of times you would go for a light normal, but Bison can space the light scissor kick where light normals don't hit. And if he spaces them where light normals don't hit, then you can't use a light normal. And if you try, your light normal is going to whiff. And if Bison does anything, it's going to beat your light normal because your light normal is going to whiff. So from ranges where he spaces it, you've got to do like a medium normal. And that is not always available depending on, you know, relative timings and stuff. Bison, like, here's a good example. That right there. If I blocked that and I was like that far away that low strong didn't hit, if I tried for a low strong, it wouldn't hit. But if Bison did a slightly delayed stand medium kick against me, it would beat my low strong. So like, Bison's trying to pressure you. He's getting you minus, but you have to look at the range that you're left at and pick a normal based on that range. You want to do the fastest thing that you can do that'll still hit from that far out, and that's what you do after blocking a scissor kick, and that's how you get Bison away from you. So like Ryu would do like stand light kick into a fireball maybe or something like that. Just to get some counter pressure. Stand like akin to EX Fireball maybe would be a super reliable one, but stand like akin to normal Fireball would be okay as well, because I don't think Bison would be able to punish it from that range. Can you Tiger Knee a super? Probably. Is it good? Probably not. Yes, you can Tiger Knee it. I'll talk about that. But like Bison will generally be more familiar with the ranges he's going to be left at than you are. So in order to beat Bison, you've got to be really quickly aware, or you know, just really practiced to know where you're going to end up based on the cancel he did, and then you need to do the correct combo from there, like, or rather the correct normals from there to hit whatever button he's about to hit. Because Bison can't actually, if you hit the right button, if I like do a light scissor kick and like, let's say, like spaced, and Ryu does stand forward and I do stand forward, Ryu's is going to win. Ryu's is going to hit first. Even though I do like a low strong as Bison, Ryu's stand forward is going to beat that because you're really minus on the light scissor kick. So the opponent, if you're hitting the right buttons as the opponent, Bison can't go for repeated scissor kicks. But you have to be crucially aware of what button is the right button for the range. Like if it's like a medium scissor kick that leaves him point blank, stand medium kick he can potentially beat with a light normal. So you don't want to hit that button. But like if it's like point blank, you can hit a light normal and it'll beat anything Bison does. Stuff like that. You just have to watch the range and hit the fastest thing you can afford to hit. What else? There's like more. Bison can counteract that, and it is super risky. But you can do a medium scissor kick or something that's like minus three, and then just do super as Bison. And it's pretty nuts. Just do something like that if they block it. But like if the opponent is just conditioned to always hitting jabs every single time they block a light scissor kick, then you're going to super them out of a jab. And that's going to, you know, fuck them up pretty bad. But that's super risky because you're banking all of your bar and doing something really unsafe. And that's Bison's only option of interrupting the opponent. So in general, you just have to play like Bison can't interrupt you. If you have a three-frame jab, then power to you. Good for this matchup. If you don't have a three-frame jab, then you're going to have a little bit of a harder time. A four-frame stand medium punch. What do you mean by that? You mean a four-frame stand jab? Bison stand strong is like seven frames. How much chip does Bison super do? Pretty good amount. Let's actually look at the exact amount. Pew. If Bison is minus two, and you do a three-frame move, and Bison does a three-frame move, yours will win. If Bison is neutral, and you do a three-frame move, and Bison does a four-frame move, you will win. Relative timings. I'm running out of things to talk about for Bison. Pretty much to get counter pressure on Bison, you just like resist with normals. And don't be afraid of reversals. And you can also rush Bison down to some degree because he has very poor reversal options. You can like you can get hyper aggressive with your rush down and not fear like some random thing interrupting you, except Bison super. Which means that Bison's vaguely weak to rush down. He also has 950 stun, which means he's vaguely even more weak to rush down. So if you're fighting Bison, you really He's a character that really functions as a like a pressure character from like a range, kind of like a like here from this general area. This is where Bison applies his pressure. So you can get closer and you're a rushdown character, or you can get farther and you're a zoning character, or you can get closer and you're a zoning character. Those are all usually good for you and not Bison. Bison wants to operate at a very specific distance where he can hit you and you can't hit him, and he can apply safe pressure. I'll probably upload this VOD as soon as I start streaming. I guess I'm running out of things to say about Bison, so that's probably it. I said I would do maybe two characters, but now I'm not really feeling whether I can do, like, another one. I feel like practicing with Laura a little bit, and also eating this soup. Yeah, I didn't talk about forward throw, dash and forward throw, because that's, like, the only... I should have mentioned that. Let me mention that right now. Like, just I'll upload this VOD, I guess, like, up to here. Bison's mix-up is really poor, apart from getting counter hits. And the only way of really opening... He doesn't have an overhead either. The only way of really getting consistent, like... consistently opening the opponent up is to do a dash and throw. And his dash is really fast, but, like, that's, like, not that great of an open-up option. So Bison, even though Bison gets white damage really easily and chip damage really easily, he's kind of poor at pushing a mix-up. I've already done Rashid. Let me just practice a little bit.